I'm Tammy Kolda, an applied mathematician. Welcome to Unlocking LaTeX Graphics. On this channel, I provide tutorials on TikZ and PGF plots, which are tools for creating graphics in LaTeX that compile along with your document. I've been using these tools for a long time in my own research papers, so I understand your frustrations. This is one of a sequence of videos in which the contents of my book, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics, are covered, and I link to the book below. If you like this channel, please subscribe, post questions, and share with your friends and colleagues. I'm assuming you've already watched the previous video. If not, check the show notes for links. Today's topic is using styles in TikZ LaTeX graphics. I'm assuming you're already familiar with LaTeX and that you've seen my previous video. If not, go back to my Getting Started with TikZ video, which I've linked in the show notes. Today we'll cover TikZ line style options for thickness, rounded corners, and line patterns. We'll also show how to create your own style, how to modify an existing style, and how to change the style of every path in your picture or your document, or even just a limited scope. I'll do everything in Overleaf, a web-based LaTeX system. So let's go ahead and visit the site. For this, we'll start a new project. We'll go ahead and call that Using Styles in TikZ LaTeX Graphics. This brings up the default page. We'll close the bar over to the left that has the file navigation. We'll enlarge the preview to 100% so that we can see a little better. And then we'll get our packages in order. So I don't need the graphics package, so I'll comment that out. I will need to add, as always, the TikZ package in order to use TikZ. And then I like to use the parskit package just because it makes things a little bit neater for these videos. The first thing we'll talk about is the thickness of the lines that are drawn in TikZ. So I went ahead and created a picture already so that we can see what's going on. Let me go ahead and compile that. And now we see the different thickness of lines as we change it. So how did I change those thicknesses? I put an option after the draw command in square brackets. And so the first one I made very thin. The second one is thin. That's actually the default width. There's semi-thick, thick, very thick. These are increasing in thickness. There's also a ultra thin and an ultra thick. If you don't like any of those, which are predefined line widths, you can specify your own line width. So I could do my own line width is 3PT or 3 point. And that would be a very thick line, thicker than any of the others. All right, the line segments I just drew had little sharp corners. So what if we wanted those corners to be rounded? So there's actually a rounded corners option. So I set up here a little figure already. So we'll go ahead and compile that. And so what I've drawn is I drew the zigzag lines as before with red. And then on top of that, I drew a rounded corner option. So the first one just rounds the one corner in that draw segment, and it rounds it by the default of 4 points. And so what you can see is it cuts that corner. It doesn't quite come up to it. It just rounds it slightly rather than going all the way to the corner. The next one I did rounded corners 3 millimeters. That's a sharper cut than 4 point. And so it rounds it a little earlier. The next one I did rounded corner equal 2 points. That's a little bit less. So it's a very slight rounding at the corner. And then finally, if you do rounded corner equals 0 point, that's actually no rounded corner at all. But if you want to turn it off for some reason, that's an option. Now we'll talk about TikZ line styles. There's a lot of different styles you can choose from. So again, I've prepared a little graphic for us to look at. So we'll go ahead and compile that. Again, we have our bunch of little line segments. The first one is just plain, just for comparison. The second one is just the regular dashed line. The next one is dotted. And there are some variations on that. There's a dash dot. There's densely dotted. There's densely dashed. And there's actually a bunch of others. If you look in my book or in the user manual, you'll find those. Lots of different line styles to choose from. Now let's talk about creating your own styles. I have a graphic already made up for us to start working on. So let's compile that and see what it looks like. So here I have my first little line segment I added some styles to. I made the line ultra thick. I said draw equals cyan and fill equals pink. So what if I wanted to reuse this? Well, one option is just copy and paste it to the other line segments that I want to have the same style, but there's a lot to copy and paste. And if I want to change something later, I have to go through and change it everywhere. So another way to do it is to create a style. You only have to set it up once, and then you can reuse it as many times as you want. So the way that you do that, I'll go ahead and get rid of that here. Then I'll put an optional argument to the TickZ picture with square brackets. I'll name my style A. You can name it whatever you want. And the way I do is A forward slash dot style is the way you set it up. And then you can close the style definition and curly braces, and then you put what you want there. And if you had multiple styles, you would just separate them by commas. And so then I can use that style over and over again for a bunch of different line segments. And then if we compile that, we get what we see here. And so now I've been able to reuse that over and over again. Now, an interesting thing you can do is you might want to modify that style just in a limited area. So suppose that I just wanted to change the definition of A a little bit for one of my things. I mean, I could just change it in line, but I'm going to be more difficult about it. And I'm going to show you the idea of a scope. So here I have a scope that just goes for these two line segments. And then I give a new definition to the style A. I'm going to make draw is red and the style is dash. So when I compile that, it affects just the one in the middle, and then the style reverts back to how it was originally defined outside of the scope. So I've changed the definition of the style A inside the scope. Now, because I put dot style, I actually just overwrote everything that existed before. I don't have to do that. I could instead append the style. So I'd say dot append style. And now I've changed the color to red, that because that came last, that overwrites what was there before. The fill stays as it was specified, and now it's a dashed line. And so that's just by appending the style, and what comes last is what is used if there's conflicting values. So first said draw equals cyan, and then I overwrote it with draw equals red. Now, if there's another option, which is you can prefix the style. If I do that, that means that this is applied before the rest of the style of A. And so we can see now that the cyan took over. So if we prefix it, the draw equals red is overwritten by the draw equals cyan when it's specified up here. But we'll go ahead and just leave this as append. Now, suppose I'm drawing multiple pictures and I want to reuse my A style over and over again. So another option is to declare that so that I can use it everywhere. So I'll go ahead and remove it from here. And then outside of that place, I can do TickZ set. And that's a command that sets the TickZ parameters from the point that it's called on forward in the document. And so here I'll go ahead and paste my definition of A. And now it's available in the current TickZ picture and anywhere else I want to use it through the remainder of the document. So there's three ways you can do it. You can have it declared at the beginning of the TickZ picture in options. You can declare it inside a scope that just is locally inside a TickZ picture, or you can declare it at the document level using TickZ set. And you can declare multiple styles, however many you need for your project. TickZ comes with a lot of predefined styles. So in this segment, we'll look at how to modify a predefined style. So let's go ahead and look at an example here, and we'll compile this. What we see is that we have these help lines that we use to sort of navigate around our grid. We use these in the last video. This help lines is a predefined style that TickZ provides. It's actually a very simple style. It's just very thin and gray. We might want to modify that style because we just don't like the way that one looks. And so the way that we can do that is we can put that in the options to the TickZ picture. We can just put help lines slash dot append style and then change it. And so here I'm going to make it densely dotted and red. When I compile this, you see that I've changed the style. If I were to just overwrite the style, then it wouldn't keep the very thin. And if I were to prefix the style, it would not keep the color. So generally you want to append the style. We'll end this video by talking about changing the style of every path in your picture or in a scope or in your document. I've set up a little example for us here. So let's go ahead and compile that. Now, suppose I wanted every line in this picture to be ultra thick. So I could go ahead and just say ultra thick in this options for the TikZ picture. So this generally works, but it's a bit of a cudgel and might have unintended consequences affecting other things. We've only learned about paths so far, but you might find that it affects things that you didn't want to affect if you just put ultra thick there. So another way you can do this is you can instead say every path's style should be ultra thick. So the way that we would write this is we'd use this magical style called every path, which is predefined, but it's actually predefined to be empty, but that's applied to every single path. So this will tell every path to be ultra thick. Now it's not every draw, because remember slash draw is a shortcut for slash path and the draw option. So we use every path to modify the draw commands. All right, so that changed everything at the picture level. We might want to do something locally. So suppose I just wanted to change a few of the paths to be something different, and I'll maybe go ahead and use a scope to do that. And so if I compile this, I just put the options directly in blue, dashed, and very thin. So the blue and dashed work, no problem, but the very thin seems to have been ignored. And that's because the every path ultra thick overwrote that. And so it sort of didn't take precedence. So if we want this to be appended to the end of every path so that it picks up that very thin, we'll do the same thing as before and go ahead and append every path. And so now the ultra thick will be overwritten in that scope by the very thin. And then if we want to do everything across the whole document, we could actually use TikZ set again and do every path at a higher level. And so this will take effect for every TikZ picture after this point. And so this way I set all of them to be draw equals orange. And so it changed all of these except for this one went back to blue because we declared that to be the default color. And that's how you can change all your paths at once.